Well, it seems as though, at least in parts of the country, the momentum is with the government forces, Aisha. Certainly, if you look around the area here in Damascus, it seems as though the government has made some vital gains in the past couple of weeks and indeed in the past couple of months. I was able to go to the southern outskirts of Damascus in the past couple of days. And what's going on there is that the government is really pushing rebel forces in that area. They won back a very key town called Zbeine about 3 weeks ago. They took that town, and the town is absolutely destroyed afterwards. The government forces are telling us that it was full of Islamist fighters. The opposition says that it was sort of a mix of fighters and that they got overrun by the government. But another place that I went to called Tadaman, which is also very, very key and actually quite close to the center of Damascus, that front line basically hasn't moved at all in the past year. It's moved forward a couple of blocks sometimes, it's moved back a couple of blocks sometimes, but what's happened in that past year is that many people on both sides of the equation have been killed. Syrian soldiers, rebels, as well as civilians. And if you look at today, there's a new figure that came out of about 125,000 people being killed in that conflict. And essentially, they're being killed in a conflict that is stalemated. Even though there are some gains currently by the government in certain areas, this is essentially a stalemated conflict. And so therefore, it just seems like this is almost a never-ending story that just keeps going towards a tragic end, if you will, Aisha.
Very much so. And today, UN Human Rights Chief Navi Pillay saying that there is evidence that implicates the highest level of the Syrian government, including President Bashar al-Assad, in war crimes and crimes against humanity. Has there been any response from the al-Assad government to this?
Yeah, there certainly has been a response by the Assad government in the form of the deputy foreign minister who is currently in The Hague, Faisal al-Mekdad, who we also spoke to last week. He said that the Syrian government gives zero credibility to the head of human rights for the UN, Navi Pillay. He says, quote, that she has talked, quote, nonsense in the past and that therefore the government isn't even listening to her. However, the statement that Navi Pillay made today is a very strong one, one that certainly we have not heard this forceful before. I want to listen in to just one of the things that she said. This is a key part of what she said.
They have now been extended three times. They've produced massive evidence. So, you know, they find the facts. Based on that, in their report, they've outlined their view that the facts point to the commission of very serious crimes, war crimes, crimes against humanity. They point to the fact that the evidence indicates responsibility at the highest level of government, including the head of state.
So a very strong statement there. The UN, of course, says that both sides have committed both war crimes as well as crimes against humanity. And one of the things that we have to keep in mind when we hear statements like that is that they are saying that these go all the way to the top of the regime. But of course, if you look at the rebel side of the equation, the opposition side, they don't really have a command structure. So it is pretty much impossible for it to go to any of the top levels. But certainly very, very bad crimes, the UN is alleging, having been committed on both sides. And as we can see, that is still ongoing, Aisha.